Daron Vaught here with a member of the gold medal winning Team USA baseball team from the Sydney Olympics in the year 2000, because it was 20 years ago today. Game one of that Olympics run was won by the guys in red, white, and blue, a 4-2 victory over Japan. Ryan Franklin, you were one of the stars of that. You came in extra innings to pitch the 10th, 11th, 12th, 13th. You gave up zero runs on zero hits and struck out four. I mean, what an emphatic arrival to the Olympics in that year. What do you remember from that game?
Man, I remember that after like the first inning of relief of 10th, I was ready to go nine innings. I mean, as long as I could. And, you know, it was an experience that I never thought that I would absolutely get to, you know, have. And just, you know, the way that started off, you know, what was the final, 2-2, I think?
Correct. So you ended up 4-2 in favor of you guys.
2-2, and then, I was fired up, and I had much adrenaline going, and I was ready to go as long as they needed me to go. Felt great, and man, what an experience, and it's one of the greatest experiences that I've ever had. I mean, even whatever all I did after, you know, the Olympics, but man, I loved every minute of it.
So I would imagine part of that adrenaline is once you got into the game, you had been an observer of your team for nine innings, right? But you probably carried some over because, all right, this is the Olympics, right? You go into the event overall with some adrenaline and some energy and readiness to get going anyway. So then you're in this tight game, and you're the one that's called upon to pitch. Did you find yourself maybe a little too amped up, right? That can happen.
Well, yeah. I mean, there's times when I do get too amped up and things usually don't go the way they're supposed to. But you just kind of got to come back down to earth and just focus on, you know, why you're there and everything. And, you know, things just kind of, you know, came in order and so happened to win it. So
what do you think that game did for you and your teammates in terms of confidence building for the tournament and, you know, just kind of readying you guys for what turned out to be this historic Olympics run?
Yeah. I mean, coming into this thing, I'm sure that Japan was probably maybe picked over us, and as was Cuba probably. And for us to jump out like that and get a big win right out the gate, I mean, it didn't do nothing but boost our confidence. And after that, we kind of just went on a roll, man.
Tell me about a pitching teammate of yours in Ben Sheets in that gold medal game as we fast forward way down the line. He had one heck of a performance. What do you remember about bearing witness to that and what was going through your mind about, man, look at this that he is accomplishing?
The thing of that with Ben is that he is so goofy that nothing like gets in his head. He thinks and he knows that he's the best out there. It doesn't matter whether it was whoever, he's the best guy, and that's the way you got to be, man. And that's the way that's how Ben pitched so many years in the big leagues, you know? So, but I mean, I was sitting down in the bullpen and I was just seeing the confidence that he was building every inning. And I'm like, man, this could be something special. And sure enough, I mean, threw up goose egg after goose egg. And next thing you know, we're on the podium. We're all crying.
Well, I'm glad you mentioned that moment. That was going to be my next question, Ryan. I mean, you guys got to experience something that very few human beings get to on planet Earth, in that you have a gold medal placed around your neck. You've got USA across your chest and the national anthem's playing. I mean, I can't even imagine the emotions that run through you at that moment. What was it like?
Man, I mean, you really, it's really unexplainable. I mean, it's, heck, you know, we were such a tight-knit team. I mean, everyone got along, and we just vibed and had the best chemistry in the world. And then to be able to do that, you know, with the guys that, heck, man, you didn't know some of them from Adam. And then after the 3 weeks we were together or whatever it was, we were like brothers, and we still, you know, are like brothers. It just brought us so close and, you know, lifelong friends. And then to be able to do that, I mean, it was the most, you know, unbelievable feeling, you know, that I could ever imagine. I mean, it was awesome.
I'm sure the camaraderie and your teammates are a large part of this. When I ask you this question, maybe go deeper than that. Mm-hmm. What does USA Baseball mean to you personally?
USA, it means it was my stepping stone to me being a Major League Baseball player. That's what it was for me. I mean, I was on the verge of, I mean, I had a cup of coffee, you know, a few months in the big leagues in 99, and then 2000, I was back in AAA, and then I was pretty much the next year, if I didn't make the team out of spring training, I was going to Japan to play professionally over there. And, you know, the Seattle Mariners saw what I did in the Olympics and saw the level of competition that I did it against. And then, you know, next thing you know, 12 years later, I'm still in the big leagues. So I truly believe that there's no chance that I would have ever gotten that time that I got the big leagues and all that stuff if it wasn't for USA Baseball.
And what about things to remember the run by? Did you keep a hold of anything? What do you have from that run in particular?
I mean, well, I had a lot of stuff, man, but like a year ago, my house burned and I lost all my memorabilia and everything.
Wow.
Yeah. But Paul Seiler, you know, my buddy, he sent me a jersey and, you know, some stuff and like a team photo of us, which was pretty cool, man. So it was special. But it's funny thing that whenever we were sifting through some rubble in when my house burned, I found a baseball from the Olympics. And it just had like a little char on it. It was underneath like some rubble. And I got that right now, which is, and there's no chance that thing would ever make it through that if you saw this fire. But it did, which is pretty cool.
That's incredible. I don't even know what to say about that. That's just one of those weird things, right?
Yeah, totally. But I mean, hey, there's something to that, man. I mean, that's, I truly believe that if it wasn't from USA Baseball, there's no way that I would have did what I did in the major leagues and been an all-star and been a part of a World Series and all that stuff. But I'll tell you what, that winning a gold medal is number one on my list of accomplishments.
So final thing for you, Ryan, why would you encourage someone to pay it forward, participate, and help fund similar experiences like yours through our Gift for Glory campaign?
I mean, that's just it. I mean, this what I just said is that it's a great stepping stone, not only to be able to put the USA, United States of America, across your chest, it's a great stepping stone to building up to where you want to get, you know, of your dream of playing in the major leagues or playing professionally or whatever it is. It's nothing but great people involved, and, you know, it's top notch across the board what they do. And man, I'm always in debt to them. So whatever they need, I'm in.